We made it to 10 episodes, y'all. This is All World Sports, where we poke fun at news related to the Knicks, Jets, sometimes Yankees. Let's go. James Dolan finally wins the draft lottery. Not really. If you've been paying attention, you'll know the New York Rangers got the number one pick in the draft. Congratulations to all my Rangers fans. So far, that's two New York teams that have won the draft lottery. With the NBA draft lottery coming up, can the Knicks be the third? President Leon Rose will represent the Knicks in a lottery Zoom call this Thursday. Many believe he's the good luck charm the Knicks need to get the number one pick. Either that, or the Tony Soprano lookalike will make them an offer they can't refuse. For more in-depth information on the draft, here's how the lottery works. There's a drawing for each of the top four picks. Then, the number one pick goes to a team that's not the Knicks. This is the first time the lottery will be held via Zoom, so hopefully it's easier to rig in the Knicks' favor. The Knicks also own the 27th and 38th pick in this year's draft, which they'll use on players you'll see in next year's playoffs playing for other teams. This week, Michael Porter Jr.'s play has been raising eyebrows. Not these. These eyebrows don't move. They're painted on. Of course, all the talk is about how the Knicks got it wrong. For once, it looks like the Knicks actually got it right. Off the court, MPJ has been in the news for all the wrong reasons. He recently stated on Snapchat that he believed the coronavirus was being used for population control. That's right, because no one likes an outspoken mulatto. No, we like her. Michael Porter was the 14th pick in the 2018 draft and sat out a year with back problems. Hopefully he doesn't re-injure his back supporting his stance on population control. On the court, though, he hasn't missed many shots. In fact, the only shots he refuses to take are the ones for the measles. Since he's never been vaccinated, he's anti-vax, and that's not a good look for New York. We need our draft picks dirty, willing to take any needles. That's what we love about New York. Another player Knicks fans have been salivating over, 5'10" point guard Frederik Edmund Van Vliet. The undrafted kid from Chicago is ready to cash in on all his hard work. I'm sorry to tell you though, he's not leaving Toronto because he's loyal. Dude has a girlfriend he's been with since high school. That's too loyal. A millionaire? You still, nah. Never mind. New York is not a good place for wealthy light-skinned dudes with a beard. He'll probably miss some games for smoking hookah at Mama Juana's. I can just picture Van Vliet on Dykeman like, démelo mi pana, que lo que. Congratulations to Van Vliet, who just had a baby boy, and it's been reported the baby is already taller than dad. The Knicks recently hired recruiting and relationship guru Kenny Payne as an assistant, and not everyone liked the move. Howard Beck, the Dikembe Mutombo of Twitter, went on Twitter to say, the Garden can't keep operating free agency this way. Get off my lawn. Ah. He caught hella backlash on Twitter and started a blocking spree that would make Mutombo proud. Beck blocks people on Twitter like Dolan blocks celebrity entrances. Payne, who becomes the highest paid assistant, has a relationship with William Wesley, who helped Payne pay players off at Kentucky. Recruit players at Kentucky because they don't, never mind. The Knicks are said to be hiring another CAA client, Mike Woodson. At this rate, we should just call the team the New York CAAs, or the CAS. A story recently came out that Scott Perry didn't want to send the New York Knicks young first rounders to the G League, feeling it would be perceived as too big a demotion, and felt practice time as well as being around NBA coaches was more vital. I have to agree. Look, when my son doesn't do well in school, I don't send him to his room. I let him hang out with unemployed comedians in dimly lit comedy clubs so he can see what real life is like. That's the way to teach him. By the way, doesn't Scott Perry look like Ronaldo Ray or Sinbad? I think it'd be dope if they did like a twins remake, like Arnold Schwarzenegger, Danny DeVito, Sinbad, and Scott Perry. Anyway, thanks for watching. Give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Leave a comment below on who you think the Knicks should draft.